My name is Janine Hume Dawson. How are you all today?
We're fine.
Great.
When was the last time you decided to impact your global community? Or have you ever impacted your global community? If not, hopefully I will be able to convince you to do so today. Today, I will be persuading you to volunteer for the nonprofit Christian organization called Feed My Starving Children. Abbreviated, it is FMSC. To my right, this is what the logo looks like. So to give you a brief history, Feed My Starving Children, again, is a nonprofit Christian organization, and they basically package meals, and they send these meals to 70 developing countries. And it was founded in 1987 by Richard Prophet. And here in this photo, these children, I don't know what country they're from, but they're eating the manna packs. Okay, so why should you volunteer? Again, as I said in the beginning, you can impact and positively impact your global community. And when I say global community, I don't mean just like, you know, your neighborhood or where you grew up or where you go to school. Global, the world. You're gonna be a part of something bigger than yourself because you're gonna be affecting so many people. And then, you know, Feed My Starving Children gives away 50 million meals away annually, and you'll also be able to prevent malnutrition in children. So my first point, impacting the global community. Most times, organizations that impact the global community will ask you for a monetary donation. You don't know where your money goes. You don't get to often see the impact of your money, and you know, the changes that could happen when you donate to them. Whereas with Feed My Starving Children, yes, they do ask for monetary donations, but the brunt of their work is just hands-on volunteering. And I'll talk about that a little bit later on. How does it work? So you're gonna sign up by going to their website, feedmystarvingchildren.org, and you're gonna select a site near you. Once you have selected a site near you where you don't have to drive for a long period of time to get there, you're going to reserve a date to volunteer. And the cool thing about this is you can volunteer by yourself, you can volunteer with friends and family. The groups can be big as 140 people and as small as one. They just need people to volunteer and to give their time. So these packaged meals, once they're packed, they're going to be, again, shipped to those 70 countries, and they actually have a 99% rate of getting to the country safely. And last year, 284 million meals were packaged. And I actually volunteered with this organization in 2013 with my youth mission group that I was a part of. And it was actually a really cool experience. They gave us t-shirts. You had to put like a hairnet on. But aside from that, you get in these stations and you're working with all packaged, the manna packs is what they're called, and you actually see them loaded into boxes, and then at the end of your shift, you see the boxes being loaded up into the trucks drive away, and they show you like a little presentation of the lives that you will be impacting. Again, some quick facts, as I previously mentioned before, it has a 99% success rate of making it to their destination. And Feed My Starving Children has been rated by the Charity Navigator for 12 consecutive years. They have the highest rating, which is 4 stars. 90% of the monetary donations that they receive actually go towards the packaged meal. So it's, you know, you don't have to worry about where your money is going or somebody's getting over on you. It goes straight into, you know, the meals. And again, I said I personally volunteered for them back in April 2013. And here are some photos. Like I said, these are the hairnets. Sometimes they can give you shirts. But these are all the people working together at the stations, as you can see in the photos. Previously, before, I talked about preventing malnutrition. So the manna packs have nutrients in them that prevent dehydration and diarrhea. And because it's given to the children, you're basically securing the future of these countries because children are the future. And the manna packs are called the manna, right? rice pack, manna potato pack D, and manna pack. Those are the three that you will pack, and those are the three that they give to the starving children. Are there any questions? Yes.
What inspired you to become a part of the organization and volunteer?
So me, I'm not a part of the organization, I just volunteered, but the thing that inspired me is my parents are immigrants. They're from Sierra Leone, Africa, and growing up I heard a lot about just the starvation and malnutrition. And malnutrition is not the only disease that you can get, because you know, if you're hungry, you know, your immune system is down. It affects a lot of things. So I just wanted to give back, not only to Africa, but just other countries all around. And just, you know, just giving a helping hand. You know, thankfully, my parents were blessed enough to come to America. And I have all these resources and opportunities here. I just want to give back. But this is my conclusion, and hopefully I've been able to inspire you to give back to the global community. Thank you for listening.